I was sent to a boys' boarding school at the age of eight. From the age of 8 to 18, I spent most of my time at first at a prep school and then at Eton. And something I ought to say, I suppose, if I'm going to be honest, something that's always puzzled me and still puzzles me is why I did not fit in either at my prep school or at my at Eton. Because ever since I left Eton, I have never found the very least difficulty in fitting into any society I've been part of, including working at the bench in a factory in Coventry. I mean, you know, I mean, I don't find it difficult to make relations with people happy, but there was something about my prep school and my and Eton in particular, which I loathed. I couldn't make terms with it. But apart from that, they taught me... Well, it's not true they taught me nothing. They did teach me something. They taught me mathematics. And Eton taught me mathematics incredibly well. And I have to be grateful to them for that. But there was no science teaching at either. Absolutely none. I mean, I just learnt no science formally at school. I mean, I learnt some science, but I learnt it because it was a good school library, that is to their credit. And I read Jeans at Eddington and Sherrington and Haldane and I read Darwin and I read a whole mass of stuff between the ages.
So you went into the school library and found these books yourself without any encouragement?
Yes, yes, essentially. Why? I don't know. I just wanted to... I found science fascinating. But... Nobody, I can't put my finger on anybody who stimulated that interest, any adult who stimulated that interest. They didn't inhibit it, they didn't prevent it, but they didn't encourage it. I mean, they didn't understand science, they didn't know about it. My schoolmaster thought that Latin and Greek were what mattered.